Hey friends, this is the very first video or pictures I'm doing of the Mudskippers after having moved them out of the little 10 gallon they've been in for the past several weeks into this 30 breeder. Same exact footprint as a 40 breeder, except it's shorter and has 10 gallons less, and like I said, it's 30 breeder. I've only just set this up and moved these guys in here maybe 2 hours ago, hour and a half, 2 hours ago. So the water's still clearing. They definitely love all the options they have in here. Started getting a little noise about that filter over there. But basically, I've got some sand that I had from another tank that I made a foundation with, and then took their sand because I wanted that beneficial bacteria, of course, and laid that down over this. In some places it's about an inch, some places it's thinner, maybe half an inch. It's a very subtle zoom in, but I'm holding some blood worms so that I hope I don't scare them too much when I go over to drop these in. They definitely recognized me. Yay, that rattle stopped. They were sitting up on the higher area up there when I came in, and they all three scuttled back into the water. Two of them are back out now. I had not fed them tonight. So they've got some dark wood. I can't remember the name of that wood, but it was in here before when I had the killies and rope fish in here. And by the way, those guys are doing well in the two tanks they went to. So this will be not only brackish, but maybe a lower pH. They really are enjoying being able to jump around on the sand. And that's wet up there, and I even scooped out a little bit, you can see there, so they could have a little bit of water in the corner there. And I am going to let this water go down about half an inch, maybe not quite that much, but I went ahead and overfilled it. I used the water from their tank too, just to get that little bit of beneficial bacteria. So what I've got going in here for filtration and circulation, kind of behind that shell that came out of their tank, everything that was in their tank came over here. Everything, because I wanted the beneficial bacteria off of it. So there's a little wave maker, an ancient one that I got like out of a $5 box maybe 4 or 5 years ago at one of the old LFS's, and it still runs. So I've got it going. It only goes on low, so it's right there in the corner, and you can see it's blowing some water. Then here, also on low, I've got a little tetra filter that's stuck to the side of the tank, and it had been in their 10 gallon and was cycling, so I definitely wanted that over here. Lots of beneficial bacteria. All the rocks came. They're floating old turtle bridge thing. There's one of them on it. And of course, they're plants which will rot themselves. They're not wilted, they just have grown toward the light in there, and I've reset them in here. They like to climb on those, so it often throws them down. And I forgot to put the lid on that filter sitting in the corner, the in-tank filter. And I don't have nearly the rocks and stuff. I've got wood and all kinds of stuff over there that they've already been exploring in, and they love that. but I've got other rocks to match this that I'm going to kind of build up. Not too high, just enough to hide that a little better, but I don't want them up there near that top. I've got it closed, got it sealed, no cracks, so hopefully they'll stay in. I never saw them climb all the way up in the 10 gallon, but they are excellent climbers. So I know they're wondering if I'm going to feed them, and I sure would like to, but I know at the same time it's probably going to spook them a little. There's one sitting on top of that wave maker. So they're all three. There's a smaller one watching me as I'm getting up. But will they run? And guys, the top of this tank is glass, but you can't see through it. It's so dirty, so I'm gonna get those scrubbed up. So I'm gonna try to put right through this crack some plug worms. Let's see where I'm at. Oh, he's ready too. Where is he at? Got him. Got him. Alright, they're already eating, so that's awesomeness. Let's see if I can get one over here to do the same. This fella, where is he? Where is he? There he is. See, that current's not very strong, and of course they'll go down and pick up all of this stuff. These guys are awesome about cleaning up and picking up, and if they see the he's over there watching, or she, it's actually a she. Let's see if I can get her to jump off. Oops. Yep, jumped before I even squirted. This is what I'm really excited about, is to be able to, when this is clear, and it will be by morning, hopefully. Isn't that cool? Isn't that cool? That's the smallest one. I'm gonna ease that down over here. Yeah, this is already 7 minutes, so I'm just gonna shut up for a minute and see if I can get any more video of them just eating. That guy is still up there. And that one, they don't want it and went back over to the little waterfall, if you will. Can't wait till it's clear. So this one hasn't eaten. So I'll make sure that one eats. All right, guys. Happy video. But, I am gonna get some fiddler crabs and put in here now that there's some substrate, and there will be more. As I said, that water level is gonna go down. So they have a couple more inches of that slope, but I'll only have to drop the water maybe. I'll have an inch of that to give them some more land. And they've got the wood over there that they can hide under. They can climb on it, sit on it underwater, or up there. The little one came up over there. And this one had moved over off the wave maker. Pretty cool stuff. I imagine I'm going to be doing some streams from here and studying these guys and observing their behavior. That's one of the really cool things about having something new, of course, is really getting to know their behavior, not just reading about them or watching somebody else's video. These guys are super social. Still got some bloodworms down in here. That would be really cool just to make the video complete. If she, that's the larger female. You see their eye, her eyes moving independently. That's the, sorry. That's the large female, the larger female. I'm pretty sure. It's hard to tell sometimes without, yeah, it is. And here comes the male. I'm not sure how he got torn up, but I noticed that during the move. It was not from the net or anything. And these guys like pellets. They like flakes. Alright guys, we're over 10 minutes. I appreciate you. love you and appreciate all your support. And give us a like if you enjoyed this. And if you want to see more, make sure you're subscribed. I'll see you in the next video.